are back with another Between the Barry and Me reaction. The turnaround is going to be quick because I got some time this week. So a few requests, since I love watching live versions, and that live version for the first song for Between the Barry and Me was terrible, but I didn't know about that beforehand. I have been given the recommendation to listen. I think I'm gonna fuck this name up, but Extremophile, I think it's called Extremophile Elite. I said that wrong. Is it Extremophile? I don't know. But anyway, I've had two or three people who said this was a great live recording. I'm gonna be able to see what the drummer does more. And supposedly it's supposed to be a pretty good song. So here we go. We are going to go and watch just directly the live version. I'm not going to go through the first step of listening to the song and then the live version, because if this is a very good live version, it shouldn't matter. So I'm excited for it, and here we go. Like it? Fuck yeah. I like his trash cymbal. Drummer's fucking sick. Guitar's fucking mustache is fucking awesome with reading glasses. Bass player's rolling. Like that switch there. I like how it went into halftime. Bye. Seriously, the drummer looks like Jesus. Maybe he is. Okay, I want to see the guitar solo. So far, like, they're mostly only doing rhythm stuff. I don't hear any leads. Like that stop. Hey, is that a Mike Portnoy Stax? It looks like a mid Stax from Mike Portnoy. The Mac Stax. Oh. Love this. Come on, where's the guitar lead? I want to see a solo. Ooh. D- dude, I'm gonna listen to this song when I'm fucking at the gym in about an hour. But I'm gonna mute the singing. Nice. Last beat. Kind of. God, dude, he's fucking sick. Nice, marimba. Tuba. I like this little switch. Not too bad. I feel like I'm playing like a Baldur's Gate RPG game. Baldur's Gate. Fucking love Baldur's Gate. There we go. Nice lead. Okay, both guitars are playing the same thing. I was waiting for them to harmonize. Like it. Dude, he uses that trash a lot, the China trash, and it's fucking sick. It sounds so good. Like that bass line. Fuck. Yes. Nice lead in. A little jazzy. It's like arpeggios almost. There's some harmony. Nice sweep. I like that drum beat. Following the rhythm. I'm telling you, the rhythm section of this band is the shit's nits. This is a very Metropolis Dance of Eternity kind of thing. I like his guitar. The look of it's nice too. That dark wood. This It's totally like a Metropolis Dance of Eternity thing. Some harmony on the vocals. Yeah. Fucking gonna seriously do a couple more reps at the gym today if I listen to this song. They didn't smile at the end or look any different. They were like, serious. After two songs, I'm pretty convinced that these guys can write some awesome music. And I would say that they definitely are very good at riffing. Like, their riffs are just like powerful and tight and really rhythmic. So I'd put them kind of, you know, especially after two songs, they're definitely a progressive, but they're more on the heavy side of progressive. Whereas like Haken and would be more on the side of a little melodic progressive, which they're still kind of over here. I'd put Dream Theater in the more melodic than I would Haken, but I would definitely put these guys farther to the right on heavier than Haken is. I guess I would put on, just to give you kind of idea of a scale, I would put like on the far left, like Yes and Genesis and those types. Dream Theater, they do, which is one of the reasons they're my favorite band, is because they do like heavy like this, but they also do very melodic, even slow songs, which I love. A lot of Dream Theater fans hate, but I think they're beautiful orchestrations and great love songs, so to speak, even though they're not about love most of the time. And I would put Haken kind of progressive over here, and then I'd put these guys as more like heavy, heavy progressive, especially with the singing. So we got to deal with that right now, because I'm just going to say, you kind of saw my face cringe when he started singing. It's not good to me. It's my opinion. Don't get angry. I had some dude leave a comment that like he was going to fucking like find me and shoot me or something. No, not really. Not that bad. But in this particular song, I would say what he's doing, I can't comment on as far as like talent wise. It's just not my cup of tea. I hate the blah, 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 blah. It turns me off completely. I could completely do without the singing in this song particularly, but I don't think that's a matter of talent so much in this song. I can't speak to the talent of what it's like to scream and growl like that in a song. I don't know. So I'm taking out the talent aspect of it. I'm just saying this is definitely something I could do without, because I hate that kind of singing in general. Now, the first song that I heard them, the Coma song, I thought he was singing more melodic stuff sometimes too, and he was very weak. That is a talent thing. That, in my opinion, I felt like his voice is very weak, didn't have a lot of breath support. That's more of a talent thing than it is a preference thing. But this is definitely more of a preference thing. I wish I could just mute his singing in this whole song. Now, there was one part, like it was a very short part, that I actually kind of liked what he did. But I would say 95% of what he did in this song is just not my cup of tea. Not a talent issue. Don't get angry. Don't yell at me. People don't like James LaBrie. That's fine. I don't get angry at him. I kind of agree with him a little bit. So now that we got that out of the way, I was waiting for them, this has been two songs now, I'm waiting for them to go off on guitar, because a couple of comments said that they are really good at guitar, and I could see him playing in the jazz section at the end. They were doing some stuff, but I would really like to see, I mean, especially if they're like progressive metal, like they're definitely on the metal end of things, he should be shredding the shit out of that guitar. So I don't want you to recommend a song that is just him shredding and the song sucks. I would like to hear a song where you guys think is good, But he also has a really, really good guitar solo that I feel like showcases his abilities to shred. And I, when I say shred, I don't mean like the musical masturbation shred. I mean like the John Petrucci shred, where it like fits the song and it's fucking incredible and how difficult it is technically. Not just blah, 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 wanking off. I'm not, you know, the Yngwie Malmsteen. Oops. So other than that, those little critiques, song was, like I said, man, I was sitting here and I'm going to go to the gym in about an hour. And when I get to the gym, I'm definitely going to pump this song out because I think it's just got the heavy riffage and that. I love that like rhythmic stuff. This band is definitely on my top list or favorites list of rhythmic riffs that are just freaking badass. And of course, Jesus Drummer is kicking shit again, and it was great to see him actually doing it. I definitely was happy that you guys requested this song, and I will definitely be listening to it again, minus the vocals. But when I'm working out, I can deal with the screaming vocals and the growling vocals, because the riffage is so good that it'll make me pump out a couple extra sets. So, hope you guys liked it again. Fast turnaround, and then we're going to try to get some more going within either this week or next week. Might not be Between the Buried and Me, we'll try something different, maybe something completely different, not even a song reaction, but please try to like everything. Be open-minded, not just song reactions. And of course, always subscribe and look out for more things coming in the future. So peace out.